UB40 have had almost 40 hits and are one of the most successful reggae bands in the world.
Biggest reggae band in the world coming from England and coming from Birmingham. I think it's great. But you would think that the biggest reggae band in the world would have come from Jamaica.
Birmingham itself has got a very high West Indian population. Basically, you couldn't move without hearing reggae.
We were living in these areas that Jamaicans were living in, and when reggae happened, when it turned from ska into rocksteady, we were there hearing it as well, you know.
In the 70s, while other kids in Birmingham had posters of the Rollers, UB40 grew up on a diet of Jamaican reggae classics.
I grew up listening to reggae because of Robin. You know, Robin used to quiz me on who produced what and what label was it on and all that, you know, when I was 10, you know, years old onwards. Come up with the idea of having a band, and a friend of ours came up with the idea of calling us UB40 because we were all on the dole. We'd been unemployed for 3 years, more or less.
We were UB40, and the fact that we'd got a job making records, you know, just seemed obvious to us to call the album Signing Off.
The name UB40 came from the form they signed to receive unemployment benefit. It was the cover for their first album, Signing Off. UB40 wrote politically charged songs like 1 in 10, the proportion of people out of work in the 80s, you know what, and you could dance to it.
One in 10 people were unemployed, you know, and what that song is just a list of statistics, you know.
It became an anthem, you know, it became something that people identified with.
After a string of chart hits, UB40 took a radical step. They called it their labor of love. The band stopped writing songs and started recording cover tracks by Jamaican reggae pioneers. Songs such as Tony Tribe's Red Red Wine, it became their first number one.
We were on a mission to promote reggae and, you know, to let everybody know what we loved. That's what the Labor of Love albums were about, you know.
But their record company hated the idea from the start.
They pretty much said to us it was a stupid idea, you know, and they talked us out of it for several albums. And then when we formed our own label, we decided to do it.
With all the Labour of Love tracks, they're all songs that we grew up listening to, that we liked, that, you know, we'd hear at school, you know, at school discos.
The stars shine so bright, but they're fading at the dawn. There is magic.
Many reggae veterans like Lord Creator, who wrote the song Kingston Town, were never paid royalties for their records.
I didn't used to get a cent royalty. Nothing. Just the £10 they paid me for recording it and nothing else.
The success of UB40's cover meant Lord Creator finally got paid his dues.
When I got this contract concerning Kingston Town with UB40, I was on my hospital bed suffering with a stroke.
And this was their way of giving something back, of actually showing the reggae world that they're not only about taking. They made a lot of reggae artists a lot of money, and UB40 are highly respected in Jamaica because of this.
I have 5.5 acres of land, and I'm putting up another big mansion, and I could buy anything I want right now. I'm thankful.
Because of UB40, they've got a new lease of life, and everybody wants their song to be covered by UB40, of course.
There will be nothing left for me. We sort of lived on Winston Groovy's version of Please Don't Make Me Cry for 10 years or something nearly. It was like a real, real classic for us.
It was a good feeling to know that, you know, that same group could admire what I was doing and covered it.
Please don't make me cry, because I know there'll be nothing left for me.
Please Don't Make Me Cry gave UB40 another huge hit, and gave Winston's music a new audience.
When we were kids, he was one of the gods, you know, and to work with him and just, you know, that's a buzz.
They were so appreciative of me, like their idol, you know? And to me, I'm just, you know, Winston. But you could see the feeling coming from them and say, okay, at last, we're gonna meet one of the men that was, you know, there from the beginning doing the reggae music. And they really gave me a warm welcome. I've been crying.
Still is for me the only music that like really gets me going, you know, really moves me. Show some sympathy.